Illegal fees are theft. Stop stealing from Nassau County residents.
Fighting words at the seat of Nassau County government where $60 million in new fees were tucked into the latest budget. Hikes on everything from red light camera tickets to most real estate transactions. Even closing out a mortgage would cost hundreds.
I think it's horrible. It's already so expensive as it is.
And they just keep going up and up and up year after year.
Now Nassau's nearly 1.5 million residents will choose who will write the next budget, with Ed Mangano facing federal corruption charges, vacating his post. Republican Jack Martins, a former state senator, and Democrat Laura Curran, a county legislator, agree fees can no longer be a backdoor tax.
It's ridiculous. It's a tax. We are the highest, we have the highest fees of anyone in the entire state.
If you take all of these fees and combine them, it would, the tax cap, it would go way over what the tax cap allows. So it's really an unfair money grab.
Fees dubbed illegal because they exceed the cost of services. But without them, how will cash-strapped Nassau make up the difference? We pressed the candidates for details.
We do paper checks, and in the age of email, is that necessary? That's over $1 million right there. Through smart management.
You can start with overtime and see that our overtime numbers are several times what they should be. We can find $60 million right there.
Both Curran and Martin say they oppose raising general taxes, but differ on how to avoid it.
I think we can do it by making sure that we bring a lot of those outside contracts in-house, make sure that we manage every penny responsibly, and get rid of the corruption tax.
What Curran, endorsed by Newsday, calls money wasted on pay-for-play deals. Martin's, endorsed by the New York Post and law enforcement.
We do not have a revenue problem in the county. We have a management problem, and with real leadership, we're going to be able to not only balance the budget, we're going to have surpluses.
But Nassau, still under the thumb of a financial control board, will likely have to answer to how it plans to make up for the shortfall immediately after Election Day, with a new county executive quickly put to the test. In Carl Place, Long Island, Carolyn Gusoff, CBS 2 News.